Doctor Who Season 6, Episodes 29 to 28, The Seas of Death, which... Me, who has the humour and the maturity of a 12-year-old, the moment I hear the seeds of death, I'm like, ugh. Death, keep your sperm away from us. And knowing it's an Ice Warrior story, I'm like, ugh! Ugh! Get away! Get away, you balloons! And like... And knowing that the seeds are balloons, and they grow as a balloon and burst out, so the seeds are bursting. And I'm like, oh my god, the doctor and the companions got the Ice Warrior seed all over them. Oh no, I couldn't help myself but laugh, because once again, I got the maturity of a 12-year-old. Like, I got all that. But, what I think of the actual story as a whole, and it is an Ice Warriors story, and we all know I'm not that crazy about the Ice Warriors in general. I was a big fan of their debut story, which was also just simply called the Ice Warriors. It was the only Doctor Who story I have ever had trouble being awake for. Like, I have watched stories, I've been doing these Doctor Who reviews when it is about 1 o'clock and 1:30 in the morning, and I got like two more episodes to cover and parts to complete the story, but I can get my thoughts across and all that type of stuff, like the Seas of Death, and still be awake. And I'm watching the Ice Warriors, so their debut story, in the middle of the day. I'm like, Yeah, but what's happening? So I was a little bit like, oh no, Ice Warriors, how does it kind of go? And it goes, here's a better story, and at the beginning I was also a little bit worried, because it feels very similar, and I felt like, is this going to be a remake of the Ice Warriors, the Ice Warriors story? Because it kind of feels the same beats, except they're heading to the moon, and there's a moon base, and they're trying to get a rocket to the moon to get some things, and the Ice Warriors are on the other side. And I was like, okay, but maybe it can work. Maybe it's just a better retelling of that story. And it is. It is a better story. Even though I think half of it is very swung, it works really well. The setting up and what the Ice Warriors are basically doing, not the plan itself, but in like the instruction of their plan and how they're going to do it and that side of things. But while watching it, I'm digging the side characters. I'm really enjoying that Zoe is the one doing stuff, is that Jamie? Because let's be honest, I guess it's the 1960s. Naturally, it's the classic, the female screams and go, ah, crazy monster, ah. There's all that, and the male companion is the one who's like, hey, doctor, I will help you. But I want to help, doctor. No, female companion, you stay there and you do something. I don't know, comb your hair or something, because it's the 1960s. Wait till we need you, or you wait till you're kidnapped, or something, right? And this, Zoe is independent. She's able to do things. She's able to help the doctor with the spaceship, because she knows the science. She's smart. Like, the problem with the croutons also with Zoe, is that she's just so, like... It's that weird balance, right? You want the companions to make mistakes, but if you make them as smart as they are, there's a problem of them doing stupid shit that contradicts their, what they are. So, with this, with the Seas of Death, I'm like, thumbs up, it works, I'm like, good on you, Zoe, and all of that. And I like the sense of terror and the sense of threat that the Ice Warriors give in this story. Then it's weird that it's called the Ice Warriors in the Ice Warriors story, debut. But you know what I mean? In their first story, let's say that. But yeah, I really dug half of it. The problem that I had with, like, the decent chunk, and maybe that's where my side drew off a little bit, because it was, like, 2 o'clock in the morning. But in the last two, the last two episodes, the problem with I had it was the plan of the Ice Warriors for me wasn't that clear. That they wanted to get their seeds of balloons, and they're bubble buff. Like, the poisonous things, it's just a bubble buff. Like, the big climax, season climax, the climax of episode 5, where the doctor's like, ah, the seeds! the seeds! It's just bubble. Paco Travers is just diving into a bubble bath. That's what he's doing. But it's like, ah, the bubbles. Ah, get me away with me. Ah. Anyway. And also I realized, like, is that Paco Travers being the voice of one of the Ice Warriors? Is he? I think he is. Huh. You know, imagine that happened now about the concept of, like, I don't know. By the way, I always thought it would be kind of cool to have a previous doctor, let's say David Tennant or something, or Matt Smith, whoever, or Peter Parody, playing the Master, not the Doctor, because it could be a way of, like, toying with A, the audience, but also the character himself. You know, the whole thing of, like, it's a multiple Doctor story, but not really. And that's a good twist around the, you know, I don't know, could work. But, anyway. But, the Ice Warrior plan doesn't really make... I was like, so they're doing this, but they want to do an invasion. And sometimes they're like, we have a fleet. Really? Because it looks like this is 3 of you, but now suddenly there's like 10 of you. I get it, you have a fleet, and I get it, dialogue, and I get it. Maybe you don't have the budget to build a ship and have like Ice Warriors tapping on your feet. To, you know, have them tapping, but I just didn't understood, and they're having an invasion, well, the bubble us, and like things happen, people die, and people, I'm like, okay, I feel like it had such a strong promise of a story, and then it kind of like the moment where, like, you know, it, when it technically is the Doctor, you know, versus the Ice Warriors, it just didn't. It felt very jumbled. It felt like they were limited by their resources and couldn't do the things they wanted to do. Even though you have the Scooby-Doo running around the corridors. Like, listen, you have, like, the Doctor running around, doing, like, running, and go, ah, Ice Warrior, turn around! Yeah, and going again. All he's missing is doing the doors. The Ice Warriors and the Doctor and what was that point? It was one of the astronauts. But yeah, I quite enjoyed the first half and, you know, most of part 4. But when we get to the meat of the story, I felt a little bit dripped off and losing track. But the next one is going to be the War Games, which is the final story of the Second Doctor. So some point there was a missing episode between 29 and 34 between, you know, 29 to 33, because I'm looking at it on BritBox and the War Games episode 1, and it's a 10-part story, so, you know, buckle my seatbelts. It's 34, so clearly there was a 4-part, 5-part story between there. So anyway, but it is the last story of the Second Doctor, and then it is onto the third one, which would be John Pertwee.